Hi, I'm Wade Wingler with the Indata Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana. You know, we're trying to get our information more digital and more mobile all the time. Mark Stewart's going to show us a really cool app called CamScanner that helps us do just that.
Hello, I'm Mark Stewart for the Indata Project at Easter Seals Crossroads. I'm an assistive technology professional here at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana. I've been recently using an app that I like quite a bit called CamScanner, and I'm using the free version, so I thought I'd show it to you so we can have a good introduction of how it works. Here we go. You'll see down at the bottom there's the picture of the camera, so that's what you can touch on to take a scan. Let's go right ahead and scan an item. It's set with the grid on, which I like. That really helps you orient, and you see how it's starting to use the camera function within the iPhone. I am working on an iPhone 5S. You can see how you can switch to batch mode. So if you want to do more than one page, you can switch over to batch. That's also an excellent feature that a lot of the scanner apps don't have. And I'm going to step away just for a moment to take a picture in some better light. It does help if the room is fairly well lit. So I tried to hold it as steady as possible. That does help. It's surprisingly accurate. The resolution is surprisingly good, but a stand would be ideal. It actually works fairly well though, just holding it steady, but that's something you want to keep in mind. Another feature of the cam scanner that I like is that you can easily crop, and I think you can see where I'm going to be going here. If I go after any of those dots, you know, it nicely magnifies where my finger is over it, and even though it's a relatively small device and I'm not on an iPad, for example, I feel like I've got quite a bit of control. That's really handy. Again, something that works especially well on this particular app. And you can rotate. And I'm going to go ahead and hit the check mark and move forward so it has processed the scan. Now if I tap on it, it'll open it up. See if we can expand it a little bit. Just spreading with, this time I'm just using my thumbs and spreading it apart to magnify the image. Pretty good, right? From the fly. You can do a lot of things with this scan now that it's created. I'm going to now tap over New Doc 2 and I can easily change the name. Just leave it New Doc 2 for now. And I went backwards. I have two documents up here. You can change the layout of the documents that you do have as such. Clicked in the upper left-hand corner there, and you've got some more control. You can tag these documents so that you can search more accurately later and more efficiently. Some of the advanced features of CamScanner allow cloud-based storage. You can email, AirPrint if that functionality is set up, fax, upload to the cloud. Get a look at how it's going to definitely look at as a PDF. You can email it to yourself. I wanted to show you the help files within CamScanner. Those are really handy, so you can go through and continue to research and learn whatever you want to learn at the time. concludes my introduction to the CamScanner app.
So there's a handy way to take that paper-based information, make it digital, make it more accessible. That's your tech tip for this week. I'm Wade Wingler with the Indata Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana.